in the Devi Upasana, when we can invoke Durga, when we invoke Durga, Durga is the destructive power. That is why in Devi Upasana we find a 9 days puja. Devi, you are there, Sarah. Oh yes, I am here, in the midst of it. Now then the 9 days Navami, when 9 days puja, then first 3 days we invoke Durga. The second 3 days we invoke Lakshmi. The last 3 days Saraswati. That's 9 days puja. After that we have the Dasara. Now then, when the first 3 days we are invoking all the three, the Durga, the Lakshmi and the Saraswati, are all Shakti, power for the infinite. Infinite in me. Now first I invoke in me the power of annihilation and destruction. The reconstruction of human personality starts by ruthlessly cutting down the jungle of negativities that we have cultivated in ourselves. Raga, dvesha, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, maharakshasan, hatva. So that in raga, dvesha, kama, krodha, the rakshasas who are in the bosom is to be annihilated, for which I must invoke my power, the mother in me, and the power of Durga, the terrible. After that annihilating for 3 days, 3 days doesn't mean 3 days annihilation, everything is over. Means it is represented, three days, at the three level. 3 days, one day poor lady, she has to destroy all these things at the body level. Second day at the mental level, third day at the intellectual level. Thus at the three levels, having annihilated them, then we start Lakshmi Sambhati. That is, after negativities are destroyed, positives are positively cultivated. Love, tolerance, mercy, kindness, goodness, not cash. Lakshmi is standing in there, that's only in calendar. You know, gold sovereign and moha is falling out of it, that is only for calendar purposes. It is the wealth of the inner world. The love, tolerance, mercy, kindness, goodness, etc. are being cultivated. Positive qualities are cultivated. An individual who has that, the negative aspects of the physical, mental, intellectual are destroyed. And the positive qualities at the body level, self-control, at the mental level, a certain amount of control that the mind is not running away, and the mind has become obedient to the intellect, and at the intellectual level, high ideas and ideals have been taught and absorbed into us by vimurshena, asheshena, asheshena, when I am vimurshanam, when I am thinking over it and I am assimilating, now Lakshmi Sambhati is developed. Such an individual alone can approach Saraswati. Saraswati representing knowledge, wisdom, Upanishad. This great knowledge, when you have that prepared yourself, then you enter to the study of knowledge, the highest knowledge. And when this highest knowledge, that for 3 days we listen, meaning for a period of time when we listen to it, the interrelationship for the gross, subtle and the causal bodies with the Paramatman, the 10th day, we reach transcending all the three planes into the infinitude. And that day is the Dashara, the day of Vidyarambha, the beginning of Vidya, knowledge, and the end of Avidya. And thus this Avidya is made into a great picture. And it is taken and burned down. And the ordinary people say, Ravana is being. And the educated man is worried, why Ravana is killed on this day? See, Devi Puja, Dasara day, Ravana is killed. Ravana represents that ten-headed monster in us, the Jnanendriyas and the Karmendriyas. To live in the flesh realm is called ignorance. That attitude of the ego is ended. Therefore, the ego is ended. That egocentric idea of indulging and living in the sensuous field and gathering our wisdom or knowledge, or I'm sorry, our happiness and the pleasure from the world outside, and to live in that level of the animal has been ended, and therefore the ten-headed effigy is being burned in the night, and this is called Dasara, the 10th day after all these sadhanas.